Hello friends, welcome to Salesforce Technical Studio. Today I gonna to describe some SFDC scenario based interview questions. So these questions are very important. So let's start. First question: what is the need of custom controller in Visual Force page? As everything can be done by the combination of standard controller and extension class. Answer: sharing setting is applied on standard object and extension by default. In case we don't want to apply sharing setting in our code, then custom controller is only option. It is possible that the functionality of page does not require any standard object or may require more than one standard object, then in that case custom controller is required. Second scenario: if in your organization person account feature is enabled, whenever you are converting the lead, how you will decide which account, business or person account, to be created? So answer: based on the company fill value on lead, we will decide whether to create business account or person account. If company fill value in lead object is blank, okay, then we will create person account on its conversion. And if company fill value on lead object is not blank, okay, in that situation we will create business account. So here third scenario: consider scenario, I'm trying to implement pagination. Initially I want to display 50 records, and when user click on next button, the records starting from 51 to 100 should get displayed. So how do I accomplish this? Answer: the key question here, how do we fetch next 50 records when user click on next? So on one possible way to implement this is to have offset used in SQL queries which fetches the records. So as example, select name from merchandise where price greater than 5, order by name limit 100 and offset value 50. If an user is not able to view reports and dashboard, how will you provide access to him to report and dashboard? Create and customize reports and manage public reports permission in profile. Okay. Let's say that scenario 5. Let's say I have a page which displays the set of records from account object, and I'm using a standard controller. Now I have two users belonging to same profile. When they log in and view this page, they get a message. Okay, so insufficient privileges. What could be the reason for this, or who would you arrive at a solution? So answer. So here are some points. So question speaks about standard object and standard controller. Also remember, permission to object is given by profile. So we need to check if the user has permission to read data of this object. Only if the permission is given to the user, he will be able to access them, else he will get an error message as insufficient privileges. How to fetch the name field from account object? Okay, so here answer: create Apex class, class name, name field of an account object. Here is the programming, you can say here. So in programming there is the step 1, step 2, step 3. So in that we write the class. First we write the class, and after that we write the Visual Force pages. So class here, so here public class, class name. So we take a list and use get set. Okay, so here, and here we can use query. So and belong to this, here that visual force pages. So how to fetch the name field from account object here. So controller, so we use that class name, and we take page block section, page block table, okay, and column header values, okay. So here can take, so this is the visual force pages. So consider scenario 7. So consider the scenario, I have a profile by name, provide read access, and two user u1 and u2 assigned to it, and I have object O, okay. So it's the object name. So my equation is, I want to have read write access for user 1 and read only access for user 2 for the object O. Okay, how do I do this? So here read access for both user is common, hence in the profile setting give read access for the object O. By doing this, user u2 will be able to read all the records. So one condition satisfied, but at this point user 1 will also be able to only read the record. Second condition not satisfied. So in that situation, so next what we do, we create a permission set, say grant write access, and in this permission set we give the object O the write access and assign the user u1, okay, to this permission set, okay. So that second condition satisfied, okay. So and finally, please subscribe me, okay, and for more information you can log in www.vinodsfdc.ca. thank you for watching.